Hey, good morning, and how are you guys doing today? I hope amazing. I'm gonna get chat up real quick while we go in. Over the weekend, I did shave my beard, just so you guys know, just in case you're thrown off and are like, "Who the heck is this dude?" Hope you guys are all rocking it. I had a great weekend. I hope you guys did. I don't know what's going on here. Boom. Okay. So we're still clearing dungeons and kicking butt. That's always exciting. I find it awesome. Got some coffee. I'm gonna let you guys know I did not get a good amount of sleep last night. Kind of woke up a little bit early. Got a bunch done on some fronts though, so that's a good thing. Let's see what we left off with in here. Get all this stuff out of here. Oh. Okay, we're clean. Okay, let's find out where we last left off. Not worried about bosses and stuff. Let's look at the map. I believe we're pretty much clear down here. That's always nice. Flip this down a little bit. Okay, all the dungeons down here are clear. All the dungeons through here are clear. Looks like we're right in this area, right? Okay, let's do it. My coffee's pretty freaking good this morning, I'm gonna just tell you guys. So, freshly shaved, got a haircut. So we're doing well this morning. Looks like we can just go right there, right? I hope you guys all had a great weekend. I went bowling last night. Honestly, I don't go bowling very much. Not that great at it, is what I know. I mean, like I don't do it very often, so you can't expect to just be exceptional at things you don't actually put time into, but I did have an okay time. I kind of thought though that I was gonna be sore. Well, these guys are jumpy attack barbarians. Okay, that was pretty easy, right? We like that. Probably a good thing it was easy because I'm still waking up. Okay, so we're on a free the prisoners mission. That's always good. By the way, I got myself my fancy notebook for when we're writing stuff. I'm excited about that. distracted me. I kind of should have noticed that trap there, honestly, but... Okay, because he's a vampire, dude, I'm gonna dodge him for a second. That guy hit pretty freaking hard.
Flesh at the new moon. Go to the cells and gather. If the new ones are weak, feed them to the maggots. We need our meat. Void up.
Okay. Focused on our focusing. Okay, we've got one more prisoner to go. Alright, found him. Tried to get me with his fancy attack. Oh, that was a pretty good attack. Get him over here real quick. Come on, vampire guy. Ooh. Good. Hey, Avalonis, good morning. I hope you're having a great day. I'm having a super smooth start to the day, I'll tell you. I'm going to let you guys know I accidentally decided I needed to wake up at like 1:30 in the morning. I'm like, holy crap. It wasn't on purpose. It was just literally a lack of being able to sleep for some reason. Yep. On Monday, we do Diablo first thing in the morning. Then this afternoon, I will do Entropy Universe. Dun, dun. Ooh, ooh. Oh, they got me. We might be almost to a boss. Travel to the feeding pit, huh? I'm gonna tell you, I'm not a fan of giant maggots, but yet I get them as a mob. And I don't know how many people have ever actually, you know, had maggots. Not like physically had them, but like, you know, been around them. They're disgusting smelling. Like super gross. Okay, we're dominating these guys. Got it. I like these one dude. Oh, he got me good. Did you guys see that? Cold dudes make me nervous because that whole freeze me stuff. Yeah. Oh, I thought we were there. Ooh, they tricked me. Come on. Well, I'm gonna fail this because this guy's scaredy cat attacking me too much. Ooh. What? Okay, what do we do now? We've got to destroy two piles of corpses type thing. Go this way, I guess. Okay, looks like we're doing good though. I was wanting a boss fight. I feel robbed on the boss fight, but... clearing out these guys anyway.
I don't have enough fury. Not ready.
That was a little bit more easy than I thought it was gonna be. Okay. Okay, let's go this one. Goat dudes. I always liked this goat dude mob. Shredded him a little bit, but you know. It is what it is. I'm gonna curve up here and take out whatever this is, unless it's like a rescue thing. Oh yeah, this is the kind we do. Good, we got her. Hit the wrong button there. Good morning, how you doing, Fire Debug? Look at that. I don't know who got me there, but they were serious. I am. I literally shaved over the weekend. Minus a small amount of hay. Oh, yeah, we're slaying everything. I think it's those little balls that are following us around that was doing the damage, though. Actually gonna be a super good week is what I'm thinking. I'm defaulting with that. Boom, got it. I'll probably have to go and turn in stuff or something like that, 'cause we're racking up so much treasure at this point. That's never a bad thing, you know, where you have, like, way too much treasure. Those guys didn't have a chance. He just smushed that poor villager. Positivity is really powerful. Negativity is also. You just don't want the negativity. I mean, it's powerful the wrong way, guys. You know what I found out about today? Because, let's just be honest, I couldn't sleep this morning, right? So, of course, I'm up randomly Googling crap and watching YouTube videos on things. So, I found out cloves are supposedly healthy for you. Like, if you eat a small amount of cloves every day, supposedly this is a good thing. You can Google it. You probably should always Google anything you're randomly hearing on the internet. You know what I mean? But yeah, I didn't know cloves were super healthy. They have like all kinds of health benefits. I don't currently eat cloves, you know what I'm saying, like as a daily thing. But I might actually like get some cloves, see what I think it does for me over a week or so, you know what I'm saying? I didn't know. Nobody's ever told me, hey, you know, if you ate a couple cloves every day, it'd be healthy for you. Nah. Hey, good morning, Rudavu. I hope you're having a great day. I hope everybody is, actually. But yeah, cloves. Hey, Lafayette Rose. I hope you're having a great day. Good morning, by the way. garlic I do eat. I love garlic. And weirdly enough, I actually like onions and stuff too. And I'm good about my drinking lime juice and stuff like that. But I didn't know that, like, cloves have just, like, a ridiculously high amount of health benefits. I mean, like, I don't know what full effect it is, you know, like, what percentage of your overall health could you, like, attribute to it. Oh, I would get coffee. I'm already coffeeing up. I literally couldn't sleep worth crap last night. So at like 1 something, 1:30, 1:45, I woke up. Then, of course, I was like randomly like watching videos and Googling stuff to see if it was true. And honestly, I was like, oh, why doesn't somebody tell me this stuff? I'm telling you guys, like, legitimately, Google, like, health benefits of cloves. It's absolutely interesting. I like cloves on ham, though. Like, if you bake a ham, yeah. I don't know if that's the same. When I was reading on it, it was talking about, like, raw cloves, so, you know. Yeah, I agree. There's so much info that you can't consume it all. I know, I'm trying. I'm just joking. I don't really try to consume it all, but you know, I do like knowing stuff, and the more random the stuff is, the more likely I'm needing to know it. I don't know why that is. It's like some kind of weird compulsion. We're dominating the crap out of this. Ooh. Oh, I think I just cleared the wrong section. Let's go this way. Oh, here's a boss, dude. It's one of those fat dude bosses. I'm gonna grab that journal real quick right off the bat. These chubby dudes, they're dangerous. You gotta watch out. They'll get ya. They got me with the scaredy cat attack. He kind of made a weird sound there. Hey, Kilman, good morning. I hope you're doing great. Oh, I thought he had me there. I thought he was going to suck me into some kind of vortex of death and get me. Okay, now I have to find out where these doors are. That's obviously going to be that way. Whew. So yeah, I felt I got a bunch done this weekend. I literally, though, yesterday when I was bowling, it was last night. I realized I'm not a great bowler. At all. So I was watching this dude bowl. I'm not serious enough about bowling. So I don't know the dude, but I was watching this guy and he was kissing his ball before he threw it. I'm not gonna kiss a ball because I don't own a ball, and it would be a random ball that's just the bowling alley. But I'm gonna let you know, his serious level was higher than mine, and he was doing super good. But it was like a bigger dude with the official I bowl all the time shirt. Oh, don't even joke. So here's what I'm gonna tell you. Because my daughter was with me and she's 5, we had the bumpers up and my score was better than normal. But I still am not that good, even with bumpers up. But the bumpers were up, legitimately. But then I kept on like watching the really serious bowlers. And man, bowlers are serious. They like do ritual stuff. I mean, not like real rituals where we're like, oh, this was an occultic ritual type thing. No, we're talking about like just silly stuff in my mind. But I'm not a good bowler, so maybe it matters. Ooh, I just got my... Ooh. But yeah, dudes were kissing their balls and their bowling balls. On the internet, you really got to specify anytime you say something like that. You know what I mean? Somebody will clip that and all of a sudden there's some video of you saying some weird stuff. Takes that much, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's an interesting thing. I don't bowl enough that I'm exposed to the rituals of what you're supposed to do as you cast your ball into the lane. But I'm gonna tell you, that dude, he was throwing it way smoother. Yeah, you gotta say that stuff. You guys know what I'm talking about. Anything can be took. You know, they tell you in political science classes never to say something that can be taken out of context in an 8-second clip. Because it will be. Oh, he got me. I thought it was fast. Yeah, take it. 100%. I told you guys I didn't sleep worth crap last night. I'll catch up later on tonight. But yeah, I noticed a lot of people own their own bowling balls. I'm in a... No, you're good. We can English meter. I don't take offense to stuff, you guys. Well, sometimes I do if it's like actually offensive. But somebody correcting a grammatical error is not going to affect my universe. In fact, it's more likely to make it where I do it less. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it doesn't hurt my feelings at all. That guy doing his little whatever attack we call that. Woo! Okay, we're gonna slay this guy. Ooh, they're gonna cold attack me. Crap. Yeah! Okay, so when I showed up, I thought maybe it was league night or something. Because everybody going into the place was getting their equipment out of their, like, cars and stuff. And that's when I knew I was not serious enough for the day. I all, like, went in there. I got some nachos. That was my plan. Nachos with jalapenos. I love those. Because, you know, if you get a real jalapeno out of your garden, it's actually hot. But for some reason, when you get the jalapenos that are from nacho-like places, like gas stations and stuff like that, they're not as hot. You know what I mean? They're like kind of calm down. They got me with the ice attack. But yeah, it was super good. I like spicy stuff, but I don't, the ones I grow in my own yard are definitely hotter. I grow jalapenos every year. And if I can, in Anaheim. I like Anaheims. Anaheims are like just a super good pepper, you guys. I don't know if you guys, I do like. You don't like gas station nachos? They're no different than bowling alley nachos. And I got the bowling alley nachos. They were good. Like, super good. But I'm gonna let you know, the Mexican restaurant I eat at, if I get a jalapeno from them, they always have the roasted jalapenos. And I'll get them once in a while. But those things, as I like to call them, I refer to them as butt burners. Because, like, you know that you're about to be in trouble. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're actually hot. Like, super hot. Like, where you're sweating and your face turns red and maybe a little bit of, you know that you're in trouble. I still eat them. Despite the fact that you think my common sense would tell me, hey, the amount of sweat that just popped out your head, that's not reasonable. Oh, one time they were so hot they gave me the hiccups. That's when you seriously know you're in trouble. Like the next day mostly. I don't know if you guys know what I'm talking about, but when you've ate something so hot that you know tomorrow you're about to be in trouble. That, like, if you get the hiccups after eating the jalapeno, and you're, like, sweating, that's like a, you know you're definitely not gonna be good tomorrow. That's what happens to me. Not everybody. Some people can just sit there eating that stuff like it's nothing. I'm like, good for you. If I eat something like that, it's not like it's nothing. It's like it's, hey, I might be in some trouble here. Still like him, though.
Anything breaks, the forge is hot.
Okay, the forge is hot. You know, I have a buddy that has a blacksmith forge. I've thought about going out to his house and learning how. I might do that. He's told me if I want to come out to his house and make a knife or something, I could do that. I probably should. Nice guy. Just so you guys know. Super cool guy. Hold on. I'm trying to get enough coffee in me to count. I don't even know what just freeze blasted me, but we'll just, See, they're always getting me with this crap. I don't know where that guy was going. Come on, faster. Okay, one more wave. Crap, I'm not getting them in time. Sometimes you have to eat food that's living on the edge. Well, you don't have to, but you know what I mean. This guy's about to get his butt kicked. And a new net axe thingy. You guys felt that was a little bit fast? Yeah, I felt it was good. I like gas station nachos. On a road trip, those are super good. I mean, it's a little hard to not make a mess while you're trying to drive and eat nachos. So it's probably not the best choice I make in... Wait. Oh, this is a different one, guys. Get our horse out. That guy tried to hit our horse. That pisses me off. If I owned a real horse and somebody was messing with it, I feel I would take it super personal. Ah. I always like horses. I think they're just a super cool looking creature. And they're so freaking powerful. In all honesty, they're like a beast. I mean, well, they are a beast, but... Besides them being like a beast, they're like just so just big, freaking powerful creatures. One time when I was younger, there was this girl and she was one of those horse riding girls. I know. And she could like ride like competition style. And I thought, oh, this girl wants me to go with her for a ride. This will be fun. This girl rode so fast, I thought I was freaking in trouble. I mean, I was absolutely scared to death. I'm gonna just be honest. She had me, like, literally almost petrified. It was not where I felt I was safe. It's okay, I was safe, but, like, legitimately, like, I was, like, clinging to this poor girl. Because she was like just galloping. And I didn't even feel we were on the freaking horse. Like it was like we were just like, ooh. Well, we were like basically floating in the air most of the horse ride. It was not the most, I would not ride that fast, just so you guys know. But if Roll's abominations take us, I did think it was neat that she could ride that fast and feel like comfortable in it. Me, personally, though, I was just, like, scared, petrified, like, for my life. Which I think is what she was going for, to be honest, like. I mean, she was nice, but holy crap, I didn't even know. It was not my finest bravery moment. I was, like, literally scared to death. It was still super fun, though. This guy's beating the tar out of me, you guys. Let's go down this way first. I don't know if you guys have ever been on a horse when some horse riding girl is like deciding to ride full gallop and stuff. But I'm gonna say, horses, they go fast as crap. Did I kill the prisoner there? I don't know what happened there. Well, this guy's dead already. I don't think we'd count him as a prisoner at this point. This is more of a recovery operation. Oh, I guess we freed his spirit. That's good. I had nachos at the bowling alley, and then I had chili cheese dogs for dinner. Yeah. That's probably why I woke up so freaking. Maybe not. I don't want to blame the food I ate for why I woke up so early. Because I wasn't having, like, stomach issues or anything. I just, like, literally was sucking at sleeping. For a second, I was trying to blame food. We don't want to blame food for stuff. That's, ooh, there's two dudes right here. Oh, these guys are gonna try to kill me. Ooh. Do you guys remember when 7-Eleven used to have- Ooh, whoa, those guys are gonna try to kill me hard. Got him out of the way. Now we gotta kill Bob over here. Oh, maybe Bob's dead already. I don't know when he died. I thought one guy was down. All of a sudden, two guys were down. What am I supposed to do here? Kill everybody. Okay. I probably have potions I could be using. I'm gonna check for a potion, guys. Okay, I'm gonna use this. Yeah, you know what? Let's not use that yet. I feel we're doing too good to just like waste a Thorn's potion on stuff. Oh, I need to figure out how to get over there. Think I need to go all the way up there or something. I don't know what I need to do. I also went to a birthday party this weekend. Seems like everybody I know is having birthdays this week. Or this month. It was super interesting. Because they had remote control cars. I know that might sound weird. But it wasn't as weird as I would have thought it would have been. So what they did is they set up a racetrack. And everybody got to try to race each other. And these were like fancy remote controls. Not like the ones I would buy. They were like, you could go fast and wreck pretty fast. So they set up a racetrack. And everybody was racetracking each other for prizes. But not like big prizes. Kind of like play prizes, you know what I mean? It was interesting. I had never thought about having a race type event at a birthday, but they're kind of into racing. So I don't know if you guys have ever seen, well, basically there's a video on YouTube where I went out to Adrenaline Adventures, and they have a YouTube channel too, by the way. So Adrenaline Adventures, it's the owners of Adrenaline Adventures that had the birthday party. It was actually super good. It was a nice birthday party. And what they decided to do, which makes kind of sense for what they do and stuff like that, because they do crazy, crazy stuff. Like, well, stuff that I'm not brave enough to do, I'm going to tell you. They like ride motorbikes up things that are like cliffs. They like ride down motorbikes down things that are like cliffs. I'll have to find you guys one of their things. I'll share it. They're nice people. I went on a ride with them, of course. but not up a cliff. I went a ride like a normal people ride, where it's like a touristy version of up a cliff, but not like up a cliff at all. Hold on one second, I'm gonna find this for you. I gotta kill these guys. And then you guys will have context to how not safe. I mean, like, it's okay. Ah, adrenaline-driven adventures right there, boom. Yeah, hold on one second, I'll find this stuff. It's crazy. They do a lot of very adventure-y adventures. Hold on. Oh yeah. I think it's a skinny ridge, but hold on. I'm trying to make sure I got the right one.
At Ocellus Academy.
Whoa. Sorry about that, guys. They're trying to commercial me real quick. I can never tell which one it is. Yeah. So they go up these cliffs, guys. So these guys' birthday party. Oh, I shaved, yes. Yeah. So at their birthday event, they had remote control cars to race. They do, what'd you call them? Those adventure destination type tourism. That's what they do. And they do it well. Like, they make good money doing it. But they have those side-by-sides and other stuff. Which, honestly, pretty fun. But they do motorcycles, side-by-sides, and basically things that are crazy. Or if you want to book a reasonable, like, hey, I don't want to die adventure, they also do those. I mean, nobody dies, but they also do, like, wilderness rescues. But those are rarely, like, they don't have to do those very much. But that is part of their business model. Ooh. Now I'm wondering where I shared that, now that I don't see it. Oh, look what we got, Chester. Seriously on this. Hold on one second, I gotta go back to a thing and sell stuff. Also figuring out, yeah, okay, I did share that. I'm never sure where my stuff goes sometimes. Dun, dun, dun. You gotta watch it when you go adventuring with certain people, especially when like they adventure for a living. Because those people, they'll get wild.
Anything breaks, the forge is hot.
They're pretty wild, actually. They're pleasant people, but man, they definitely, like, make a living going at, like, super high speeds all the time. But, if you're ever like, hey, I mean, like, they go on adventures for a living. Like, they own a company that provides adventure destination type things. So, like, you go to them and you book an adventure. And they take you on a tour or a motorbike ride or or scuba diving, like random stuff. Like you want to go to some weird place, you got some kind of destination, you need somebody to like equip you, take you, go there with you, they do that. Woo! You see how they almost got me there? I'll give you guys the link. Yeah. So like they rent a whole lot of equipment and they take people on adventure tours. So like the link I tried to share that didn't share obviously was an attempt to show you. No, they like go up freaking cliffs, you guys. Like real like things that are not good. So at one point I worked with them on their YouTube channel, and most of their YouTube videos would get flagged for promoting dangerous content. And like it's just what they do. Like they like will take a motorbike and go at like a speed that's not okay, right? And hit freaking and go up a hill that's like this, that's like hundreds of foot up, and just and then like flip around at the top and come down. And so it's super crazy. That's like how they make their living. I've been on their little adventures, but not a big adventure. I went and messed around with them. So I have a video on my channel. Yeah, they basically do adrenaline. Yeah, it's called Adrenaline Driven Adventures is their company. And literally that's what they sell is, do you want an adventure where you're gonna go and do something fun? They also will take you on a non-death defying adventure. You don't have to go on a death-defying adventure. You can just go on a normal adventure with them. They'll also take you on one where you don't feel like you're gonna die. You know what I mean? But they do have fun. So their birthday, of course, was super interesting because it was oriented around what kind of people they are, right? So we raced remote control cars. And that was their theme, was racing. Except, like, reasonable racing, and nobody was racing. They're just super fast remote cars. Like, I don't even know where they get them. So, their non-death-defying adventures are still pretty fun. Like, just for the record. I don't know if the thing shared, but I'm going to let you guys know that, nah, hold on one second. I'll find someone. I'll get their link real quick. So you guys have their link. Because I'm going to tell you. They do different stuff. They do also, like, they take brides out sometimes. I don't mean like karting, but kind of like karting. I don't know if that popped in. I mean like, you know, for some reason my links aren't coming through. I'm not really sure why. I mean like crazy, not safe stuff is what I mean. Like really crazy stuff. I'm trying to find it. Hold on one second. I'll make it where you guys can see what's up. And we'll try not to die, right? Okay, so I'm showing you guys. I know that this is not what we're doing really. So I mean like this kind of stuff. I'm gonna have to wait till it gets past. So this is their company. Watch this. So this dude is gonna be flying. See these cliffs right here? He's going up those. Hold on. Yep. This is their channel. Don't worry, he's gonna hit those cliffs in a second. They flagged this video. I did this video for him. I did not ride. But they flagged this video as promoting dangerous and unsafe behavior. See, he's hitting the cliff right now. Boom, that's him going up. So he's gonna go up it right there. Boom, he's at the tops. See those people down there? Boom. He goes down, don't worry. So they do like this stuff, random, like all kinds of random stuff. And basically he just rips the thing to pieces the whole time. But basically they just go and drive really fast, but they'll take you on tours. See, watch, right here. So that's these cliffs back here. So it doesn't look like... So that's what they do. And here, like scuba diving, weird stuff. They take people on tours. They take brides on tours sometimes. Just that kind of stuff. The adventure I went on with them was not a death-defying one. These are like, see, they go on these kinds, serpent's trails and stuff like that, go up things. That's basically what they do. That's how what they do for a living, though. So, and by the way, they're all very good at driving. They're very good at driving. Like, I'm not that good at driving. I'm not about to be like, hey, you know what I need to do? Hop on a motorbike this morning and haul butt up a cliff. But I went on like a lesser adventure with them where it was just like boom, and it was pretty fun. It's on my channel. It was super nice people, guys. But yeah, that's their living. That's how they provide. Which, by the way, they love. Hey, good morning, by the way. Hope you guys are all doing amazing. I thought it was fun. Okay, now we gotta go and kill the boss. So yeah, that's what they do. They just like play, basically. I mean, they don't just play. They have to run a business while doing all that. And in all honesty, guys, it took them a little bit to build that business up. Like they were working like their real normal jobs while building that up. And so it wasn't just a, hey, let's go play all the time. Well, I'm glad you're not having any issues. Getting this guy took down. I will tell you, when I was doing their videos for them and helping them out, it was pretty easy to throw together a video based off of their stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not that complicated to figure out, hey, I'm gonna put some music to this, and you guys are, I'm gonna just post this. Like, I had to do some editing and stuff like that once in a great while. Hey, well, Fire Debug, I hope you have a great day at work. It's gonna be a pretty pimp day, honestly, guys. I don't know why, but I'm gonna cool the cooling of the wicked. Yeah, they do have a good lifestyle though, because of that. Just so you guys know, like, they've done a lot of fun stuff that most people like have to pay to go do, or don't even go do. And they get to just most of the time do it for fun. You know what I mean? Just like, hey, I gotta go to work. And go to work means like, I gotta go drive my motorbike at some ridiculous amount of speed. In which, when I have to go to work, I have to like do stuff. I mean, they do stuff too, right? But
not ready yet.
I'm gonna let you know, they like their job a lot. I've never heard them be like, woo woo, I hate what I'm doing. Even when they're not having that great of a business, like, so during the whole like thing, obviously you couldn't go be you weren't able to go take people on super cool adventures as easy, and so that really did hurt their business a lot. But they ended up making it through it, you know what I'm saying? And now they're just like flush with happiness. I think that they're doing pretty freaking good. Oh, it took a while. Yeah. They dumped a lot of their life into that business, guys. Like, to the point to, like, keep that business going, they made choices. Choices that a lot of people wouldn't make. So during the whole thing, you know what I'm talking about, the thing we're all not allowed to talk about for some reason. That business almost went under because there was nobody to like come in and do stuff, right? So they literally sold their house, moved into a camper, and stayed on like the back lot of their business property until like things turned okay again. Like, they literally sacrificed hand over fist for that company. Like, flat out, you guys. And that's what it takes sometimes. If you really want something and you're passionate about it, you'll like, put everything on. And people thought they were crazy about it. You know what I'm saying? They're like, oh, I can't believe you'd do that. Even I'm going to be honest, kind of was like, shocked that they were willing to like sell their house to keep that thing afloat during the downturn and stuff like that. But they did, and they made it succeed. And I'm gonna tell you now, they're not regretting it. Now they're back in a bigger house. They still have their business. But yeah, it took a while to be profitable, and right when they were profitable, the whole thing happened with everything. And so it was a huge deal, you guys. Huge deal. It was super stressful. And the thing is, they didn't want to fire employees or anything. And so like they sacrificed to keep employees on and to keep that business going in a way that most people would never. Well, I agree. Most people, though, I'm going to tell you, they're not thick-skinned enough for it. They're not going to be like, you know what? I'm willing to risk, like, all kinds of stuff over this thing I believe in. They actually did, and I thought, I have mad respect for that, you guys. I'm not saying that that's going to work out for everybody the same, but legit, it takes knowing and believing in what you want to do to be like, you know what? I'm going to sell my house. I don't want to fire my employees. I want to be able to keep my business going. Bad enough to do that. Most people would never do that. ever. And so, huge respect for that kind of sacrifice. Especially because, you know, anymore, there's so much social scrutiny in, like, everything people do. No. Like, if you do something, somebody's gonna scrutinize it, right? And so they faced a lot of scrutiny over the fact that they were willing to, like, sell their house and go all in on this business that some people thought was frivolous. You know? You gotta really have confidence in what you think you're doing, though, at that point. But I will respect that over the play it safe person every day. And I'm not telling everybody to go out. You know, it is, yes. Yeah, it's similar. Kind of interesting, huh? If you believe in it, though, that big, you know, it is what it is, guys. If you really believe and you're willing to go all in, sometimes it works out. Sometimes, guys, though, they lose everything. I mean, they did it, and it worked out in those, you know, in that case. But I'm going to tell you, if it wouldn't have worked out, people would have said, oh, you guys were fools. Oh, I can't believe you guys did that. Blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? And so I'm glad it worked out. On top of that, if I ever want to go get a cool video that looks like slightly adventury, but not like their adventury, they would be more than glad to help me. And they have all the equipment for getting your own videos. Like, they have a drone dude. They have GoPros and all the stuff you could need. You can rent a gimbal from them and take a gimbal on your ride. They'll drive for you if you're not comfortable driving like a crazy person. And they'll get you an awesome, holy crap. And there's been a few YouTube-type people that have went paid and were like, hey, including Instagram people, that just paid them to take them on an adventure and get them a killer video. Oh, wait, as soon as the commercial stuff's over, I'll tell you what it is. Oh wait, you have no ability to. So. Oh, see, they're trying to mess us over here. So what a gimbal is a gimbal is a really fancy recording device that has like a camera on it, and it has like a stick, and if I were going like this shaking it, it would just self-stabilize, and you would get this perfectly stabilized shot. Yeah, I forgot. And so, they have those for the people that are wanting, like, super high-quality videos. Like, where there's none of the jarring around, it's all, like, perfectly stabilized. A gimbal basically makes you a good cameraman. Even if you're not. Just so you guys know. Yeah, they're actually fancy as crap. They're expensive. And so. But yeah, they're mostly used by like people that get high quality videos. Like, super high quality. But you get really good video off of them. Yeah. So that's what they're used for. So you can't... You're not going to shake if you have a gimbal. It's like the anti-shake camera. Has self-stabilization and all kinds of other stuff. And so people will rent them if they like are serious. That's how you know if somebody's super serious about what they're getting. Like a lot of people will just get some GoPro cameras and stuff like that. And then once in a while you'll have like somebody that comes in and they're like, I'm gonna need a gimbal and this and that. And that means that they're like seriously getting content media videos. Like, or maybe not always, but you know, for the most part, your normal dude doesn't need that kind of piece of equipment. I would buy one if I had like, if I were doing that kind of stuff. I would get one though. I don't go and do crazy stuff as a, like if you were a skateboarder and you were wanting to skateboard while being wild, you could literally do all your stuff and it would just hold it stabilized and you could lock it onto yourself. So you could sit there and be like, boom, I'm locked onto me, and it would literally just, yeah, they're fascinating. It's super good quality equipment, guys. Uh-oh. I thought I killed this guy for some reason. Yeah, I would get a gimbal. I don't do that kind of stuff though. Or I would own one. Yeah, I'll show you guys what I'm talking about. Hold on one second. Let's... Oh, whoa. My thing is totally off today. Hold on, guys. I didn't realize my screen was not even set right. You guys are seeing part of it. I don't know how I didn't notice that. Okay, let's find a gimbal real quick, and I'll show you a gimbal footage. Now my video captures... Yeah, we're just a mess. I'm a little bit of a mess today, guys. So this is a gimbal type thing, but it'll literally stabilize even your phone. This guy just has the stick gimbal, but they have fancy ones. And see how it'll stabilize anything he's moving? It doesn't matter. You see that stuff? Oh, whoa. No, you don't. Okay, hold on one second. Now you'll see it. So see this guy right here? I don't know
this
him.
This is a real being.
Hold on. They're always trying to make me listen to stuff. Okay, display on. Boom. Skip. See this? That's a gimbal in his hand. And see how as he moves... It doesn't do anything. I know. I got it now. So this device right there, that's a gimbal. And they have them with the like recording devices and cameras and stuff like that on. So see how it'll lock onto something and it doesn't move at all. Like you can literally walk around. It literally will self-stabilize all your movements. And so... He isn't going to be able to mess up his own shot. I don't know who that dude is, but gimbals are normally not locked to smartphones, just so you guys know. But good for that guy. I'll go along with him having locked to his smartphone. That's a little awkward, but But yeah, that's what a gimbal is. It's basically a self-stabilizing type thing. Now we've got this set normal. I don't know why I didn't realize my thing was not at the right stuff. You guys did see it though, right? All my settings got messed with somehow. I must have done an update or something. That could kill you guys. You gotta watch that. But yeah, it's basically a little hand wand. And you can go like that. So like if you're on a thing, an adventure, and you're trying to get good footage, you use a gimbal. And it'll self-stabilize all your craziness. Which is nice, right? I'm gonna have to kill this poison dude. I'm gonna be honest though, guys. Most normal people don't use a gimbal. Like, it's literally like your dudes that are content media guys, basically. Oh, I did! Hold on. I'm back now. Yeah. Thank you for telling me. I didn't notice. I'm a mess today. This is what happens if I wake up at 1:30 in the morning, you guys. I should not wake up at 1:30 in the morning. I don't have my crap together when we do that. We gotta get up here because this guy's vampire mode. Wait until he's done vampire moding. I think he just died. I usually only wake up at 3:15 actually, exactly. So 1 in the morning is or 1:30 in the morning. It was not 1. It was 1:30, but you know what I mean? Not the type. I did shave. But I did warn everybody I was gonna shave for like a little bit before I did. Yeah, it's too early. It's okay because I got way coffeeed up. Hence the random stuff, right? Seriously on this, we're always just overflowed on stuff. I like that we get so much stuff, but yeah, 1:30, and you don't have anything to do at 1:30, right? Yeah, and then I won't have to be shaved soon enough. Yeah, it's a mixed bag. I also have short hair currently. Look at this. Yeah. My hair's all cut. blah, blah, blah. I look kind of almost like not a homeless person. Yeah. It's a work in progress. I don't like to, you know, have to look like the dude out of the Matrix stuff, like Mr. Smith all the time. And so I'm a big fan of just not having to do that stuff. But then everybody would rather me look like an anal person, to be honest. I'm pretty anal sometimes. I'll admit to that. I'm not. Sometimes I'm overly, like, serious. Sometimes I'm not. It's a mixed bag, right? Everybody's a mixed bag of stuff. We're getting a huge collection of random things, you guys. Ooh. I'm gonna have to go through our treasure one day and figure out if I have better stuff to switch to. I'm gonna assume that's that. Since we have like a whole pile of... You know, like a serious person. Yeah. When you look overly serious and overly everything, it's probably not the best thing to call it, but that's what some people call it. You know, when you're so... I probably shouldn't have called it that. Now I realize that my mistaken terminology, don't call it that. Got it. But you guys understand when you're over serious looking, like there's an overly serious... Oh! Yeah. That's what I call it, at least, when somebody's just serious to the max for no reason. But I do realize how that probably was not the best thing to call it at all. I do now, in hindsight, realize the flaw of that. Yeah. Ooh, they're trying to get us. Yeah, you know, I have way, way too many random ways I say things, and I should realize that maybe people aren't from my area, and they might not call it the same stuff, and I probably should watch what I call things. But yeah, I just mean it as overly serious looking. Ooh. But I won't use that term anymore. Honestly, it could also get my videos in trouble somehow, I'm sure, because somebody could think I'm saying it differently. And all of a sudden, you know what I mean? Then all of a sudden I'm being flagged for saying some stuff. And I'm like... Okay, that one's done too now. I'm ripping through these. I would contest the demonetization on something like that. I would ask them to watch the video for full context, at minimum, you know, and hope that they at least would. I'm gonna pop to here because it looks like that's the closest spot. Hey, thank you very much for lurking. I hope you're having a great day. Man, I'm hoping everybody's having a good day. Super excited for this week, though. Like, majorly excited. Okay, where's our next? Our next... Well, we have to clear this whole area, guys. Let's go down and get this one.
I can't do that here.
Yeah, somebody could literally think I'm talking about, like, inappropriate things. Never know what somebody thinks, you know. I feel like I just was a bull in a china closet there. I broke so much stuff riding over there. Not good. Well, I'm glad it's your afternoon. Is most of your day doing really good, though? Look at this guy. Not used to. Yeah, I agree. Thank you guys for being such a nice supporters and stuff. You guys are always so positive too, you know that? I really appreciate that. I know some people have a super negative experience streaming. I've had a super positive one. And I'm glad. Because honestly, if it was super negative, nobody'd want to do it. You know what I'm saying? Oh, wait. I'm trying to free this guy. Okay, where am I going? Buildings are such giant buildings. I thought somebody was up in my house. It threw me off for a second. They do wake up around this time, so. Always never know. Oh, these guys are in trouble. We've got four more prisoners. Okay, these snowflake dudes have to die. Oh! You know, that is really the truth. Having a good community, super valuable. Woo! They got so close to killing me. Oh, I'm trying not to. Honestly, what's happening is my energy is starting to drop a little bit in real life. And I'm realizing that I'm gonna probably have to really get my crap together before I have to actually do stuff today. I don't know how that guy died.
My savior.
Okay, real quick. Ready? We're grabbing this. Oh, that's wasteful. Super wasteful, guys. Oh, I'm coffeeed already. I'm gonna have to actually make some more. I'm gonna honestly get a shower is what I'm gonna do. That ought to wake me up a little bit, then some more coffee in me. And then all I gotta do is make it through the day. Which sometimes is an actual challenge. When you're that tired. It's not a challenge in real life, you know, where you're like, oh, I don't know if I'll be able to make it through this. I'm not in one of those situations like that, thank God. But, yeah, really thank God for that. I'm super blessed. Like, I don't have any of those, hey, horrific situations going on. Nobody I know has something going on where I have to be like super concerned about, hey, is this person okay? Oh, I just want to sleep. But the thing is, though, We're past that being an option. So at this point, it's gonna just be a hey. When I'm done with the day though, boom, I'm gonna sleep, and I'm gonna sleep hard. And I like sleep. Just for the record, I think sleep is super good. Especially if I have some kind of weird dreams. That's always cool. You know, I actually like weird dreams. Not ones that distress me or give me horrible anxiety. I don't like that. But just like, hey, that was totally surreal and out of my normal thinking. I like that. I'm about to, woo! Yeah, that guy's down.
My savior.
Now I gotta find out where, oh, there's where I'm going. Oh. Okay, now we're going. You know, it was at one point for me too. Lately, I've been having pretty vivid dreams. Sometimes they're pretty nice. Sometimes they're like, WTF, what did I eat wrong? I actually have never had food do that for me, really, but... But once in a while, I'll have some serious vivid dreams. In which sometimes they're good, sometimes they're like not so good. Okay. Oh, I get you. So I had a flying dream once that was super good. The other day I had a dream that made no sense, and I literally told the randomness in my dream, this makes no freaking sense, and then I woke up. But it made no sense. It was like a whole dream of nonsensical, like, didn't even make sense at all. But last week, I had a dream I was going to this giant university, and the only thing anybody at that university was doing was like partying, and basically the university was just a mall and a bunch of bars, right? But I couldn't remember where I parked my car, and there were all these different parking lots, like a bunch of parking lots, and I had no idea what my car looked like either. So I couldn't find my car. I didn't know what it looked like. People wanted to help me find my car, but they wanted me to come have a drink first. I kept on just wanting to find my car and go home. You know what I mean? It was super. When you don't know where your car in your random dream is. I'm not a party, no. I don't drink really. And so here's the deal, guys. I'm not good at drinking. And then on top of that, I would never go and drink a bunch and drive a vehicle at all. And I couldn't find my car. And so all I wanted to do is find my car. You know what I'm saying? And so I didn't want to go drink a bunch of stuff or go clubbing. I just wanted to find my car so I could go home. And so for me, it was just stressful, to be honest. Like, because I didn't want to sit there drinking with everybody. Plus, I like to party, but I like mellow partying. Like if somebody wants to go camping, and we're gonna have s'mores and have a couple drinks up in the mountains, I'm totally good with that. A couple drinks. But I've explained to you guys, I'm not a good drinker. So like, I'm a lightweight. I can't really handle alcohol. And so like, I like to just more relaxed. And on top of that, when people are like belligerently drunk, I don't like that. I don't like being around it. I like chill type situations where people aren't being crazy and stuff. I partied in college and I felt that I got plenty of partying out of the way in college. You know, everybody's different. I will go and have a margarita with Mexican food. No, this is a save people one. I don't like these. I suck at these. We'll pretend we're good at this for a second.
I can't leave my friends here. Not like this.
Yeah, I'm just not a big drinker and I'm not good at it even, so. And I don't want to become a good drinker. And so, so at that birthday party, I did drink some kind of lemonade that was an alcohol beverage. It was okay. I didn't think it was amazing for sure though. But it was okay. Plus, I don't like to be sick the next day if you do drink too much. Like, some people don't get hangovers. I get hangovers. I'm not that good at drinking. I never succeed at keeping these people alive. And so to me, drinking's just like, I like a drink, not to drink. Like, and in my dream, at that college, the people were drinking heavy, like, in a way that I don't. And honestly, I've seen too many fights start because people are drunk. And so when somebody's like super drunk, I just take that as my time to like be like, hey, you guys have a good night type thing and head out. I don't hang around if people are like way, way drunk. So I can get a hangover from a beer. not a beer, but like if I had two or three beers, that's a lot for me. Like some people can just drink beers and it doesn't, it's like nothing. Me, if I drink beers, I'm gonna be the dude that's seared, like drunk. And I'm not mean when I'm drunk, thank God. But I don't get drunk very often either, so that's kind of another thank God. I don't actually get drunk anymore. I think the last time I was drunk, I was going to college, to be honest, guys. And then it was literally just a social because everybody I was around literally drank, like, hard. But I didn't really have that much fun drinking, so... to me, it was not that great of a deal. I'm not a big fan of super big drinking. I like a margarita type drinking. Or, if I go to a barbecue place, I'll get a beer. Like, I'll get a Dirty Hippie or something like that, which is a type of beer, guys. It's not a, I'm not being mean to hippies. There's a beer that we have here in Colorado called Dirty Hippie. You might have it there too, I don't know. But it's freaking good. It's not super, like, hoppy or anything. And it goes good with barbecue food. So sorry, guys. I wasn't meaning to yawn at ya.
I must wait.
Not gonna do it. Oh, Heineken's okay. That's a reasonable one. I just messed up by using that. Hold on. You know what? I don't even care about it. Let's just go back. We'll drop some stuff off. Heineken is popular. I didn't know that it was a Dutch beer. Good to know. But yes, Heineken's super popular over here. Lots of people like that one. What's going on here? Hold on. Oh! That makes sense. I'm going to tell you what, the Dutch did a lot of sailing, a lot of sea trade. A lot of people think it was only like the Italians and Spanish and stuff like that. But man, the Dutch had an entire trade empire for a long time. You already know that, but I think that stuff's fascinating. A lot of people also, though, don't actually realize that the Dutch were were involved in the colonization of the Americas. I even meet people from America that don't know that the Dutch heavily contributed to America. Like our penal system, a lot of the settlements over here, there were a lot of settlers. My understanding is that the earthworms over here came from Dutch settlers bringing their flower pots. It's kind of weird how we get so many things that we don't remember how they actually came into being in most cases. I think it's fascinating. Okay, going back here and picking up this stuff. That's how we get over full. Oh! Yeah! You were the one telling me about you guys' wait, is you guys have the crazy princess? I'm still fascinated at whoever told me they had a crazy princess. I haven't got a chance to look her up. I need to. Okay, so somebody was telling me that they have a princess that's crazy. The Norway guy, yes. Norway. I didn't even realize Norway had princesses. But I, for some reason, ooh, look at all this poison, guys. I think it's fascinating that they have a crazy princess. And I don't know her personally, so she might be crazy like in a way that's not as crazy as I'm thinking. But from what he was saying, it did sound like she was pretty crazy. Do you guys have a princess? You know, for us over in America, a lot of people, I'm going to tell you, even though we don't have any of that stuff, are obsessed with the royals over in England. I'm not personally. I don't care about that stuff. I'm like different celebrities at this point. But tons of other people are super, super into monarchs. I don't know. It's interesting. Yeah. I gotta figure out which way to go. I'm gonna go down this way and hope we find some. Three princesses? Are they cute? Do you guys have cute princesses? I'm gonna have to look this up. Not this second, you guys. I'll wait till later to look up the princesses of Norway. I would think you guys have pretty princesses, though, because the Norwegian people are really nice looking. I don't know anything about Liechtenstein. Well, is Liechtenstein its own country? I've never even heard of this place. Liechtenstein, huh? Ah, see, now I'm gonna have to learn about Liechtenstein. I don't know anything about it. Weird. Well, good for them, I guess, being a monarch in a modern world. I hope they're at least nice with their monarchiness. I'm not that worried about the type of government, more about like how it treats its people than anything. A good emperor could be nice if they're nice. And a bad democracy can be horrific if it's horrific, you know? I forget about that stuff still being a thing, though.
Help, please.
No, lady, I'm not helping you. We already beat this dungeon. We're just in fights with everybody. Yeah, see, that's the thing. If you have a good leader and a popular leader, people are okay with different forms of government than they would normally be. And so, I honestly think more people are concerned with am I being treated well than anything else. Okay, so since it's 7:01, we're going to get ourselves back to... Boom. Yeah, that's fascinating. I didn't know about Liechtenstein. I've never actually seen pictures of it either. So I'll probably check into what Liechtenstein looks like. And I'll be looking up you guys as princesses. Three princesses. I don't even know what you do with that many princesses. Like, because it's not like there's, like, princes all over the world to marry off your princess daughters to, right? Is that still a rule? do princesses have to marry a prince? I don't know how that works. Could they just marry some random dude? I mean, I don't know. Kind of fascinating. I'll be looking it up. Oh, it was never a rule in the Netherlands? Okay, good. Good to know. So some random dude could end up being married to Princess of the Netherlands. That's super cool. Okay, guys, I'm going to raid over to somebody real quick. I'm going to try to make sure our stuff is not messed up in the future. Let's just be honest. I don't know what. Every time I do a restart on my computer and stuff like that, an update, it likes to go and do stuff where it messes with all my screen stuff. Let's see. Boom. Looks like we've got Tooniversal. I don't know how it always does this thing where it jumps up to the beginning of chat right before I raid. Okay, thank you guys so much for hanging out. I hope you guys have a great start to the week. I will see you on Wednesday morning. We're working on our book. And then, of course, tonight we're going to be doing Entropia Universe. And so that'll be fun. I always like Entropia, and I'm really excited about this book. It's flowing. I think we're going to be kicking butt on that. Peace, very best wishes, and you guys stay epic.